Okay, here we are in my workshop. Today we're going to mount some DynaDuke plates to Lhasa POW skis, and I want to show you how you're going to do it, and you can apply this to basically any kind of binding that you might have. First off, you want to download the paper template that we've got in Tech Talk. You're going to need a ruler, scissors, you'll need a hammer and some kind of marking punch, some sharp object. You'll also need a number 3 positive drive screwdriver. You'll need a 3.6 millimeter drill bit, unless you've got metal in your skis, in which case it's a 4.1. So I'm going to start off by taking the paper templates. Very first off, take my ruler. I'm going to check the print scaling. So I'm going to take the ruler and measure and make sure that the scale on the print is exactly matching up inch for inch. And it is good. If it wasn't right, you'd go ahead and try printing again, see if you can get it to scale 100%. The next thing I want to do here is I want to mark up this ski, and I want to get a perfect center line marked on the ski, as well as the boot center line, so that when we put this template on, we can line it up really neatly. So first I'm going to mark the boot center line, which is already marked on this ski. And then what I'm going to do is try to mark a perfect line lengthways down the ski that's perfectly centered on the ski. So I'm going to take my ruler and measure the width and make a mark which is exactly in the center. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4.5 inches wide. I'm going to make the mark right at 2.25. And do the same thing down at this end. You can be as precise about this as you can possibly be. Get the marks there, and then what I want to do here is draw a real nice line here down the length of the ski so that we've got a reference down the middle of the ski. Like I said, you want to be as careful as you possibly can at this step. This is going to really affect your mount. All right, then we want to make sure you find out what size boot you're going to mount for. And I'm going to be mounting for these Titans here. They've got a 322 millimeter boot center, or boot sole length. And so I'm going to take the toe pattern, and I'm going to punch a hole centered right around the centered right around in that area, the 322, so that I can see through this pattern right at the 322 area. And I'm doing the same thing with the heel piece. Can't quite get my hole punch far enough. So now I should be able to see through and get the boot center line perfectly on. Okay, I'm gonna line it up first by hand. And I'm trying to center right here, as well as center the BSL line and center at the rear too. We'll take a couple pieces of tape here and we'll get it on there just as accurately as we possibly can. Your time with this part, it's pretty important. And I've got that perfectly lined up there. Okay, got the heel template on. Do the same thing with the toe template. Again, I'm centering, getting this line perfectly straight in the front and the back, as well as lining up the BSL line as accurately as I possibly can. I got that taped down, and one last thing, I'm going to show you how to double check that this is perfectly centered. You'll notice that there's some scale marks here on the template, here, in the back and the front, and what I'm going to do is count in and make sure that when I fold this over, it folds in exactly the same scale mark on both sides. Do that on the front and the back. That'll just double check it. Perfect. We're nice and straight. I've got myself on the 322 BSL for both the front and the rear. At this point, if I had, you know, whatever bindings you're using, I like to just sort of dry fit them just to give myself a little bit of a double check, make sure things are looking right. And in this case, I'm just going to do this here. I'll dry fit the Duke on top, which is good. And everything's looking to line up nicely.